What's everybody, this is Planet Mars Gamma Girl, and in this video I'm going to be showing you different ways to play The Sims 4 so that it can actually be fun, because you know, some people are starting to get bored, and you know, sometimes The Sims can get boring, but if you play it the right way, or in, you know, in different ways, you eventually like it. So for number one, I'm just going to start off with what everyone knows is challenges, and right there, that's like the legacy challenge. You got the 100 baby challenge. If you don't know what that is, you can look it up, but it's pretty popular. But one that I really recommend is Super Sim, where you basically just complete every aspiration, every skill, complete every career. Like, you know, things that you can do in the game, you just complete it. And that just takes up a lot of time, and it's very fun. Like right here, I'm like bringing up my acting skill, so I can end up getting that 2 hours plus thing right there. And you know, that's Super Sim. Another thing that I ended up actually finding was that there's this website that is like a 100 day cast challenge. So every single day there's a challenge, and you have to make that sim the way that it's made, which it is pretty cool. And this challenge is actually day 12, so it says, I think it's day 12, but I'm gonna link both of them. But this challenge is where you have to make sims in different age groups. Jesus, for some reason I couldn't say that. Sims in different age groups, and you can either do different sims or you can do the same sim, but I did the same sim. And this is Caden Coleman. He's in obviously different age groups, you know, teen, toddlers, stuff like that. And the problem with this though is that it's so addicting that you might just like do like 30 days but in one day. Like, that's how addicting it is. But if you're someone that can take it slow and you like to only do like casts, and you know, there's different challenges from like, it can just be building, just be making sims, or a game plan. And I think that's what's cool about the challenges, because if you're not like really a player but you love to build, you can do stuff like that. There's a challenge for everything, and all you literally have to do is just look it up and you will find a lot of them. I can almost 100% guarantee it. I said almost, but yes, I can. Number two is create/play with stories. So right here, this is the Hart family, and I ended up writing a story for them. Now, you can play in that story, and it'll be fun because it's a story you made, or you can play in a story that The Sims actually made. Like, right now, I'm in the BFF's household. And in the story, it's supposed to be where Summer Holiday and Liberty Lee both have feelings for Travis Scott, but don't know how to tell him. So, eventually, I start to play out through the story. And what's crazy is that you get to choose what you want to happen. So look at this. I ended up making Summer Holiday become Travis's soulmate, and they end up kissing, and in 5 seconds they're already in the shower together. And you know, I made that decision. But then, look, she's going to check if she's pregnant, but she is not, and that ends up devastating her. I mean, well, she stays confident, so she should have been devastated, but she's devastated. But then, wait a minute, Travis Scott ends up kissing Liberty Lee, and then I made Summer Holiday end up walking into the room while things are going down, is all I can pretty much say. But look at her, she's doomed in a doomed relationship, because she ends up, I guess she has, no, it doesn't say jealousy trait, it just says jealousy in general. So she's just pretty much jealous, but Liberty Lee, she doesn't care. But Travis Scott is embarrassed, so it's crazy from the way that I play with the story, it ends up changing their mood, and she ends up slapping Travis Scott. And look at this, Liberty Lee's actually pregnant. So instead of the story going the way that I thought it was gonna go, I ended up actually getting the other girl pregnant. And now Summer Holiday is very upset, and she ends up walking out of the room. And from the way that I played that story, now Travis Scott, he's living with a big problem. But number three is to have an extended family, which means you can just basically add uncles, aunts. It could be your family members or family members of other Sims in the town, which I like to do. And I'll get later on to that when we end up getting to, like, number seven or whatever the number is. But on to number four. Have goals. What I mean by goals is that you can have, like, skill goals if you want to have a certain skill by a certain time. Or you can have, like, a house goal. There's basically a house that my sim right here has been wanting for ages. And it's this house right here. But the only way for her to get into this house is that she has to be a 5-star celebrity, and she has to have $300,000 left. You can make any goal that you want, or I could have done it to where she has to be able to have her acting skill all the way at the top and be at the top of her acting job to be able to move into this house. It's the goals that you make that can make you want to play the game, because yeah, The Sims should have had it in it, but it's okay. But now she ended up becoming a 5-star celebrity, she has $300,000 left, and she gets to own this big house. Like, yeah, those were two small goals, and you're probably like, wow, but you can make a lot of the goals into the bigger goals, if that makes sense. And look at her now. She can watch a movie in her new home that she ended up achieving. And like, the goals, you can literally do it with anything. Like if you want to go onto a rocket ship, and the only way for you to get on that rocket ship, you have to upgrade everything, or you have to go to university just to become a judge. And you know, university takes up your whole young adulthood, so you might as well, unless you do different stuff. But then you add more goals. Goals is what does it. Number 5 is change up your gameplay. Instead of playing with just like a whole regular house of family, have like a man right here that has 3 children, but the oldest daughter is not his wife's daughter, so she treats her very differently than the last two. And now, instead of making all your Sims get along, you can always make the stepmother just yell at the older daughter, even when she's just doing her homework. But number 6, write down things. I ended up getting this from a different YouTuber, and I'll definitely link her channel, but you can write down things from, like, it can be Sims that you end up having crushes on, it can be Sims that are your, like, your best friends, and why you met them, and how you met them. Like, if you met Bjorn, I think is his name, at a bar, you write which bar, you write what day, how you guys met, what type of friends you are, if you guys just laugh a lot when you're together, or if you guys just travel around together. You can end up creating his personality based off of his traits and aspirations, and to just see how they are as a person. You can write down why you're trying to gain a skill, if you want to gain a skill so you can repair your sink to where it doesn't break, or if you want to gain a skill just so you can, you know, become a better person, or, you know, just random stuff like that. Number 7 is doing townie makeovers / rebuilds. Now right here, I'm remaking over Johnny's Zest, and townie makeovers are basically where Sims that were in your town that Maxis had made, and you just make them either look better, or you just change how they look in general. But I just like to make them look better than what they actually look like, and a lot of people like to do that. And you can also add on to the family, like if you want them to have a kid, if you want them to have a brother, and you know, you just keep the legacy going for every household in the town. And it also takes up a lot of time to do, so if you love to create a Sim, if you love to build, this is definitely something that you should look forward to, and you're probably gonna love to do it. And when you do townie rebuilds, you can either just change up like decor or different stuff in the house, or you can just full on bulldoze it and create your own house and do it your own way, which I like to do it both ways. I feel like it's fun for me. I'm just gonna throw together a little house right here, so don't judge me off of it. I can make it better, okay? I just, you know, I had to make it like that just so this video can be made, pretty much. But yeah, number 8 is try new / use things that you already used. Like, for instance, I never lived in Windenburg, and basically I'm gonna move into this house that I don't even know what it looks like, because that's how badly it is. Like, there's so many towns in my game that I have not visited, and I'm gonna end up trying this out when I end up playing again. And I'm going to actually do different things. I used to always just live in an apartment, but now I'm doing this. You can also buy new items, like that bed that I just bought, and I would never put this inside of a house, these flowers and stuff like that, and I ended up using it, and I actually like it. Also, you can find new objects, like, for instance, like, I don't know how this happened, but I genuinely found this chair, and I've been more happy since, because it kind of reminds me of the chair that I got, and it just, like, it was great. Or you can, you know, wear clothes that you never really wore before. You know, use the game, guys. Like, there's so many packs, game packs and stuff packs. I mean, expansion packs, whatever, all 3. But there's also one thing we all used to use, which is outdoor retreat. We should give vacations another chance. And, you know, I just feel like vacations are actually really a fun part if you use it correctly. And yeah, you know, it's probably a bad vacation spot, but it's okay. Just play the game, guys. Number 9, add new Sims to connect with. Like, this household that is made right here is the Hart family. And me and my brother actually ended up making this family. He made the girl, I made the guy. And, you know, the child just came out. And blah, blah, blah. And I have such a strong connection with them that every time I see them, it's like I'm seeing a character that Max has made type of connection. So, it's definitely fun when you end up adding players that, you know, you would love to just see walking around. You can do like celebrities and stuff like that, which would make that way more realistic and way more fun. Or you can just go to the gallery and move anybody in. But yeah, with the celebrities, I'm not making one right here, I'm just making Sims, but with the celebrities, it's actually pretty fun to do. The celebrities, like, luckily Get Famous is in here, but you guys should definitely add celebrities. It'll bring way more fun to the game, because you can be like, oh, I want to meet Rihanna, and in real life, and which a lot of people probably do. You could throw it right in the game, and now you can, you know, meet her. But if you feel like it's weird, then it's weird. But number 10 is slow down, right? We all end up playing the game, and we tend to fast forward a lot, which ends up making us feel like we're doing the same thing over and over. Slow the game down, refrain from the fast forward button. You can obviously click it if you're like doing something, but just refrain from it. You should, when you're talking to somebody and you want to end up dating them, don't, like, you know, the first person you meet, I'm gonna first say this, the first person you meet isn't always the first person you end up marrying and having kids with. So why do we do that in The Sims? We should end up taking it seriously. So instead of dating the first person we meet, we end up dating by the fifth person that we end up meeting, or maybe even the 10th. Just do breakups, have divorces, you know, have kids with other, with another dude. Make it so that, you know, child support, that he's always around. You end up dropping off the kid sometimes. Like, do it like that. Or instead of going for a jog around your neighborhood, you end up going to the park to go for a jog instead. Do different things in the game and just take it slow and actually feel the moment. Especially when you play with a sim that looks just like you, you can definitely feel the moment. I mean, she doesn't look just like me, but it reminds me of me. The way I used to make myself is not like this, and I'm so proud. But, or you can go to the gallery and just download a bowling alley and just go bowling. Live in the moment. Play the game like it's real life. You can go bowling and next thing later, Chris Brown just walks through the door. Depends on where you're at, but it can happen. But, my sim just goes there and she embarrasses herself in front of her crush. I wish having a crush in the game was real, but you know, I'll make a video on that of like things that The Sims should have, or you know, little details, because there's a lot of things. Or you can just go to the gallery and get a movie theater. And the reason why we're sitting so far apart and we look a little awkward was because Judith Ward actually walked in, sat in between us, and then got up just to make us look weird. Like, no, we're friends, we're cool. We just don't know if she's sitting back down. Or you can really just, I hate how I keep saying or, but you can pay attention to your kids. So how she's feeling sad, instead of just having your sim, well, not to your kids, but just your sims in general, but instead of having your sims just talk in the mirror or whatever, talk on a hotline, have the mother walk up to the child and discuss the mood. Have the mother calm her down and, you know, just do different stuff like that. Have her give her a hug, have her talk to her just so she can feel better, instead of just making you, instead of doing the same thing you always do when your sim feels sad. Make the game feel realistic. You can have it to where your sim praises her daughter after she ends up, after she ends up gaining a skill playing the guitar. Like, you can do a lot of different things. And just play the game slow and actually play it like it's real life. I feel like people just, they end up repeating everything that they're doing because they rather just get through the day and they rather just can't wait for their kid to grow up, but live in the moment. Like, how you should live in the moment in real life, live in the moment like it's in The Sims as well. And remember in the beginning about creating the stories, like, why is she sad? You could end up creating that story or make her upset because of her friend ends up dying, but, you know, they're not friends with anybody else in the house. Like, it would just be really cool to end up doing. And I just feel like we all have to get used to just playing the game slow, because it will just make the game way more fun. Now, you, instead of like just sitting around, you could teach your child flashcards and actually do it. Don't just, you know, stop. But yeah, actually have a bond with your child. When you yell at your child, make sure you hug them or something, or put them in timeout. Make sure you end up saying you are sorry. Snuggle with your kid. Just bond with them and bond with these sims to make the game more fun. And refrain from the fast forward button. Remember that. But I will see you guys in the next video, and I can definitely make another part of this if anybody really wants it, because I know a lot of ways that people can play The Sims and actually have fun. And also, I can do different types of videos with The Sims, like certain stuff packs and game packs. Like, you know, I'm gonna get all into that. But peace, hope you guys enjoyed the video.